The story of human migration is an extraordinary tale that spans thousands of years and countless generations. Through the analysis of DNA, historical records, and archaeological evidence, we can unravel the fascinating journeys our ancestors undertook, ultimately leading to the diverse nations we have today. Genetic studies have revealed that all modern humans can trace their roots back to Africa, where our earliest ancestors originated. The Out of Africa theory, widely accepted by scientists, suggests that, anatomically, modern humans originated in Africa and gradually migrated out of the continent. Substantial evidence supporting this theory has been unraveled. Through the analysis of genetic markers such as mitochondrial DNA, Y chromosome markers, and most effectively, autosomal DNA, researchers have been able to dig up great findings on the genetic lineages of populations and uncover intriguing connections. The implementation of these genetic markers in population genetics and ancestry studies have provided valuable insights into the genetic history and relationships among individuals, populations, and even species. Moving forward, as human populations gradually migrated out of Africa, they embarked on remarkable voyages across vast landscapes and encountered a multitude of environments. These journeys were driven by various factors, including the search for new resources, exploration, and the gradual colonization of different regions. As populations settled in diverse environments, they faced new challenges such as climatic variations, food availability, and the need to adapt to different living conditions. The migrations that led to the establishment of present-day China were no exception. Embark on a mesmerizing journey with us in this video through time and space as we delve into the direct descendancy of the Chinese population from Africa. In this story of migration, adaptation, and interconnectedness, we glimpse the tapestry of human history, a tapestry in which the Chinese people are woven with threads of Africa, Asia, and the world at large. Before we get right into it, be kind enough to touch that like button, share as well to others in thirst of information, and subscribe so you don't get to ever miss out on more interesting updates in the future. Let us continue. It has been proven that the first men in China were black. An international study has found that the Chinese people originated not from Peking Man in northern China, but from early humans in East Africa who moved through South Asia to China some 100,000 years ago, Hong Kong's Ming Pao Daily reported, in a finding that confirms the single origin theory in anthropology. In China, school textbooks teach that the Chinese race evolved from Peking Man, based on a theory that humans in Europe and Asia evolved from local species. But DNA specialist Jin Ling and his fellow researchers found that early humans belonged to different species, of which only the East African species developed into modern humans. This new finding nullifies the theory that the ancestors of the Chinese people were Peking Man, who lived in northern China 400,000 years ago. The Chinese narrative, which stretches the evidence by leaps and bounds in the interests of nationalism rather than well-balanced academic inquiry, has been heavily discredited and criticized. The lack of hominin discoveries in China in comparison to Africa, which continues to regularly produce fossils, illustrates that Africa was a much more genetically diverse region of the world in the distant past, which is an indicator of its greater age. The findings, however, that the Chinese people are descended from Africans, by even Chinese themselves, amongst other genetic scientists from other regions of the world, added new weight to existing theories that all human life began in Africa. Academics from the University of Texas and their colleagues in China studied 28 population groups in China and concluded that most, if not all, had their genetic origins in Africa. They looked at pieces of DNA known as microsatellites, which are short repeating DNA segments that yield information about genetic variation among people. The researchers found that all Chinese have a great deal in common genetically, although there are some regional variations. The findings, published by the National Academy of Sciences in Washington, supports what has come to be known as the Out of Africa theory. This theory contends that Homo sapiens, the modern form of human life, is descended from a population of ancestors who migrated out of Africa about 100,000 years ago. Based on DNA analyses of 100,000 samples gathered from around the world, a number of human families evolved in East Africa some 150,000 years ago, said Li Hui, a member of Jin Ling's team. About 100,000 years ago, some of those humans began to leave Africa, with some people moving to China via South and Southeast Asia, Lee stated. This research was conducted by an international team of researchers from Brazil, Russia, India, and other nations in a 5-year project studying the geographic and genealogical roots related to the spread and settlement of modern humans. The new data also supports the idea of an African Eve, who is an ancestor of all living humans. The Eve hypothesis, first published in 1987, suggests that all human DNA can be traced back to a single female. This Eve would have lived in Africa about 200,000 years ago. The latest research challenges an alternative theory which holds that several different groups of humans evolved separately at the same time in several places around the world. Chinese mythology holds that the Chinese are descended from a single ancestor, the Yellow Emperor. More recent Chinese scholarship has argued that the Chinese evolved separately from other races. H. Imbert, a French anthropologist, stated in his book Les Negritos de la Chine, the Negroid races peopled at some time all the south of India, Indochina, and China. The south of Indochina actually has now pure Negritos as the Semangs and mixed as the Malays and the Sakais. Another author and professor, Chang Sing Lang, revealed similar information in his writing on the importation of Negro slaves to China under the Tang Dynasty. Even the sacred Manchu Dynasty shows this Negro strain. The lower part of the face of the Emperor Puyi of Manchukuo, direct descendant of the Manchu rulers of China, is most distinctly Negroid. These professors, through their research and studies, have reason to believe that a Negro empire actually existed at the dawn of the country's history, citing evidence of substantial populations of blacks in early China, including finding reports of a major kingdom ruled by blacks being frequently mentioned in historical Chinese history documents. And Chinese chroniclers report that a Negro empire existed in the south of China at the dawn of that country's history. The notion that blacks were the original inhabitants of China has been thwarted by white scientists and even some blacks as the result of a sweeping message of white superiority and inferiority of black Africans and their descendants spreading worldwide. In 2005, DNA testing proved that the first inhabitants of China were black Africans. The study, conducted by the Chinese DNA specialist Jin Ling, a team of Chinese and other scientists, proves this fact. Lee admits that he wasn't even trying to prove this actually, never had the intention to do so. Instead, he initially wanted to prove that the Chinese evolved from Homo erectus independently of all humans. After collecting more than 12,000 DNA samples from 165 different ethnic groups, Lee and his team found that early humans belonged to different species, but modern humans had descended from the East African species. Curious, isn't it? Let's quickly take a look then at what the genetic markers have uncovered for us, shall we? The migration. The Chinese ancient populations ventured from Africa into Southwest Asia, following various routes. One notable route is believed to have been through the Arabian Peninsula, their feet leaving imprints on the shifting sands, footsteps echoing through lush forests and verdant plains, leading them, with each passing generation, they ventured further, venturing to the Indian subcontinent and further into Southeast Asia. From there, they would have eventually made their way into what is now modern-day China, a land brimming with breathtaking landscapes and untold possibilities. The transformative nature of human migration is remarkable. These migrations were neither swift nor linear, but rather occurred over extended periods, inevitably involving multiple waves of human movement and also the change of physical attributes. Such was the case of the Chinese, genetic mixing. During the migrations of ancient humans, populations interacted with and assimilated local groups, resulting in genetic mixing and the establishment of diverse ancestries. In the case of the Chinese population, genetic studies have uncovered fascinating links between East Asians and other populations. For example, the Han Chinese, the largest ethnic group in China, exhibit genetic connections to populations in Central Asia, Siberia, and even as far as Polynesia. These connections can be traced back to ancient migrations and interactions between different groups of people. One intriguing study conducted in 2019 by a team of scientists from the Chinese Academy of Sciences examined the genetic diversity of ethnic minority groups in China. The researchers found evidence suggesting that some ethnic minority populations in China, such as the Yi and Tibetan peoples, share genetic similarities with populations in Southeast Asia and the Pacific Islands. These findings hint at ancient migration routes and interactions that shape the genetic landscape of China. Moreover, DNA analysis has shed light on the genetic contributions of ancient hominin species, such as Neanderthals and Denisovans, to modern human populations. It has been discovered that these archaic human relatives interbred with our direct ancestors as they migrated out of Africa. As a result, many modern non-African populations carry traces of Neanderthal or Denisovan DNA, including East Asians, including the Chinese. Historical records and archaeological evidence also shed light on the connections between Africa and ancient China. Trade routes, such as the famous Silk Road, facilitated cultural and genetic exchanges between East Asia and other parts of the world, including Africa. The Silk Road served as a conduit for not only goods, but also ideas, technologies, and human migrations. It connected civilizations and fostered cross-cultural interactions, contributing to the rich tapestry of human history. Change in physical attributes. However, as populations settled in different regions, they also experienced changes in climate, dietary patterns, and other environmental factors that influenced their physical attributes. One notable example is the evolution of skin color. The melanin pigment in human skin, responsible for its coloration, gradually adapted to local conditions. In regions with intense sunlight and higher UV radiation, such as Africa, natural selection favored darker skin tones as a protective mechanism against harmful radiation. However, as populations migrated to regions with lower UV radiation levels, such as East Asia, where sunlight is often diffused by cloud cover, natural selection favored lighter skin tones to facilitate the production of vitamin D in the absence of intense sunlight. This adaptation to different climates and levels of sunlight likely contributed to the variation in skin color we observe today in modern populations. Another distinctive physical feature often associated with East Asians, including the Chinese, is the shape of their eyes. The epicanthic fold, which gives the appearance of slanted eyes, is a common trait observed in many East Asian populations. The exact origin and evolutionary significance of this feature are still subject to scientific debate. Some theories suggest that it may be an adaptation to protect against harsh winds, sunlight, or extreme cold temperatures prevalent in certain regions. Others propose that it could be a result of genetic drift or sexual selection. It is important to note that not all East Asians exhibit this trait, and its presence can vary within different Chinese ethnic groups. It is important to emphasize that genetic research is an ongoing field,